students, welcome back in online class. In our previous some videos, we have started our first lesson, what is history. In this, we are learning about history and what is the importance of history for us. So, dear students, we have seen that history is a science. What is history? History is a science that tells us about the events in the past. So, we have seen history is a science that tells us about the events that have taken place in the past. The next thing we learn about the scientific method. The method of using a number of different tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable. So we have seen the scientific method. A method which does many tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable, to be trustworthy or not. Okay? Now, today, again we are going to learn about the scientific method. The next thing, see, it's not possible to conduct experiments to recreate the events that have happened in the past. Is it possible that after doing some experiment, after getting some evidences, we do again experiment and we recreate the events that have taken place already in the past? Can we recreate the events? No, we cannot recreate the events. But what we can do? We can study about the event by the evidences we got. Yes? But we cannot recreate the event. Yes or no? Something happened yesterday. Can that happen again? Can that happen the same again? No. We cannot recreate the event. The method of presenting history is different than the other sciences. So the method of presenting history is different than other sciences. Like we have different sciences, but method of presenting history is different. We cannot present history in the same way as other sciences. Okay? So the method of presenting history is different. Even so, history uses the scientific method at every stage, namely while looking for and collecting evidences. See, even though the presenting of history is different than other science, but this history uses science at every stage for collecting evidences, identifying them, looking for evidences. So this history uses science at every stage. The next thing is, help is taken from other sciences when required. See, to study history, sometimes we take help from other sciences. Sometimes we have to take help from other sciences to study history, because always we cannot use the other sciences, but sometimes whenever it is required, we take help from other sciences to study history. Okay? And that is why history is considered to be a scientific discipline. We take help from other sciences. That's why history is considered to be the what? Scientific discipline. History is considered as the scientific discipline. History is not written solely on the basis of imagination. Is history just imaginary story? No. History is not just an imaginary story. It is not written on just imagination that somebody imagined, okay, in before 2 years, these things had happened. If somebody imagined like that and wrote, is it like that? No, history is not written on the basis of imagination. To write history, many things have taken place. To write history, scientists did do experiment a lot. They find so many things, they find so many objects, so many cultures, so many books, and then after understanding all, they write the history. So history is not just an imaginary story. So there are sources of history. there are sources of history. With the help of the sources of history, we write the history. So there are three sources. What are those three sources? Material sources, written sources, and oral sources. There are three sources. We find, scientists define, they study, and then they write the history. So first is material source, second is written source, and third is oral source. So what are the things that come in material source? You see, things that come in material source are coins. See, different kinds of coins. Okay, archaeologists dig the earth, dig the soil, and under the soil they find different objects like coins. Okay, now these coins are not what we use today. Are these the coins we use today? No, these are not the coins we use today. These are the coins used in the history. Before many years, people use these coins. So these coins come under material source. Okay? So archaeologists find the coins. Again, ancient objects. So many different objects they find. After digging under the soil, they get so many objects. So these objects, ancient pots, these coins, sculptures, these are all things they find in material sources, and they study these things, they examine these things, they do experiments on these things, and then they find the truth, whether it is reliable or no, and then they write the history according to the things they find. Now what are the written sources? Books. Written sources such as books. See, books written many years before, these manuscripts written many years before, copper plates, things written on copper plates. So these are the written sources we find after digging the earth. So scientists they find, archaeologists they find these things. And what are the oral things? Oral things such as traditional stories and songs remembered over many generations. So oral sources means what? Traditional songs, traditional stories, which are remembered by many generations, and they told to their sons or daughter, again they say to their children, they say to their children, and they, the songs and the stories, they come to us. So these songs, these oral stories are the other sources, oral sources of finding about the history. So these are the three sources of history which help us understand the history, understand the things that have taken place in the past. In order to find out history, evidences available from all these sources are collected and examined to determine its reality, its reliability. See, to find out the history, these evidences, okay, whatever the evidences got from these all the sources, these evidences are collected, they are examined to determine whether they are from the history or no, whether they are trustworthy or no, whether they are reliable or no. So these evidences, they are examined, they are collected, they are examined carefully to write the history. With the help of these evidences, the historical account is written. If the evidences are reliable, if the evidences are reliable, they are kept according to the state, and then according to that, the account of history is written. Historical account is written, and this is the scientific method. So dear student, this was all about the scientific method of history. So this is the scientific method. I'll tell you short. Okay? See, the first thing, there are three historical sources, okay? And from these sources, many evidences are found. These evidences are examined, they are collected, they are studied carefully, and if they are reliable, according to that, the historical account is written or the history is written. And that is all known as the scientific method of history. So, dear students, I hope you understood the scientific method of history. In our next video, we will learn more about this chapter.